I'm not going to talk about COVID-19 today. I'm not an expert on it. But I wish to talk about emotions. I wish to talk about anxiety. And more specifically, what do we do with it? Last few days, I'm literally carrying a lot of heaviness in my heart, thinking about the community, the people of the world who are struggling, who are fighting against this deadly pandemic. On one hand, we can put that aside saying that it's just an anxiety, it's an emotion, it's bad. But internally, I feel that emotions are valued. They are here for a reason. One part of me says, retreat, withdraw, stand out of it. It's anxiety, managing anxiety. It can be very difficult. It can be very difficult to handle because it comes with a lot of uncertainty. But other part of me says, wait, there's something important is happening. And actually, when we feel big, there's definitely something big happening. It may not be accurate, but something big is definitely happening. In times of uncertainty like this, the most important question we need to ask ourselves is, how do we want to see ourselves 5 or 10 years later? 5 or 10 years later, when we look back at ourselves, we want to see, how did we react? What was our role? What was our contribution? These are so powerful questions. It can shift us out of this moment of urgency. It shifts the whole pressure which we are feeling in the back of our head and says, wait, there's more to the story. There's more to our story. There's more to my story. There are people who are suffering. There are people who need help. The neuroscience of stress says that brain constantly pushes us to focus in the short-term survival and protection. So it's going to tell us, close the door, retreat, withdraw. And that's not how we solve the problems. That's not how we know it. In fact, that's not how we move forward. And most of us, we need to move forward. We need to look upward. We need to look ahead. We must tap into our emotions and access the future. Future of us, future of our connection with the world, its people, its community. And most importantly, we need to look into the future and then look back at ourselves, that how did we play in the times of uncertainty like this? How do we want to narrate our stories to the future generation? So let's all practice what we want to see ourselves, and let's do our best. God bless.